first saw him, I was amazed at his talent to be 10 years old. It was just incredible.
From child prodigy to cultural icon.
This man was the greatest recording artist of our time. This man, through his music, actually like made a change in the world.
The king of pop.
Michael had an unseen magic to influence people. Through music, you know, culture and music would not be what it is without Michael Jackson.
The soundtrack of a generation.
Michael Jackson doesn't just come along once in a century or a lifetime. He only comes along once.
Falls silent at age 50.
My brother, the legendary king of pop, Michael Jackson, passed away on Thursday, June 25th, 2009 at 2:26 p.m.
As his life was controversial,
he raised the bar for image makeovers to a point where no one else wants to even come close to it.
So is his death.
This is something which I feared, and it is something which I warned about. Where there is smoke, there is fire. This is a case of abuse of medications.
Millions in mourning. They are mourning in Gary, Indiana, too, Michael's hometown. He was the seventh of nine children. Flags at half staff, a memorial at his childhood home. His steelworker father, Joe, turned five of his boys into a band, with five-year-old Michael out front. One of their first venues, the Auditorium of Roosevelt High. Here, the Jackson Five won the talent contest and wowed the crowd.
Oh, it was just unbelievable because they were so young, but yet they were so talented. They performed as if they had been performing for years, and we were so excited.
From the high school auditorium to the big time.
Okay, let's go.
Media mogul Suzanne DePass was there at the beginning.
I was asked to come to see this group.
DePass was just starting out at Motown, working with founder Berry Gordy.
I saw these kids, and they were unbelievable. And I called Mr. Gordy and I said, oh, I've just seen the most fantastic act.
When she told me about another kids group, I said, wait a minute, I got all these other stars.
I went back one more time, mustered up all my courage, and I said, Mr. Gordy, you just have to see these kids.
Suzanne DePast insisted that I meet with these kids and audition them.
An audition seen in this video from a documentary produced by Michael Jackson.
They were sensations. They were tremendous. And the lead singer, Michael, was just so incredible. And immediately, I was up all night trying to think of the type of song that would create excitement among people.
Motown gave the group a record deal, and the Jacksons began their rocket rise to stardom.
From the time that most kids were building tree houses, Michael Jackson was building an image. At the age of 10, he was told to say that he was 8. And Michael was happy to play along with that because he understood at a very early age that image making and public relations was very important.
It worked. The Jackson 5 exploded on the charts. Their first three singles, I Want You Back, ABC, and The Love You Save, all hit number one.
The sound was incredible. The weight, the gravity, the way he would sing. And then he would dance. You know, I mean, and his brothers are on stage with him. I mean, you couldn't stop him.
But behind the image of a happy family and their rags-to-riches story, there was something else. Incredibly hard work and a father who pushed his children. In 1993, Jackson spoke about both in this interview with Oprah Winfrey.
I would do my schooling, which was 3 hours with a tutor. Then right after that, you know, I'd go to the recording studio and record, and I'd record for hours and hours till it was time to go to sleep. So it'd be nighttime, and I remember going to the recording studio. There was a park across the street, and I'd see all the children playing, and they'd be rooting and making noise, and I would cry. It'd make me sad that I would have to go and work instead. Oh, there was a lot of sadness about my past life and, you know, adolescence and my father and all of those things. It just made me very, very, very sad.
So he would tease you, make fun of you?
Yes.
Would he... Did he ever beat you?
Yes.
He did?
Yes.
And that was difficult to take, getting yes. beaten and going on stage and performing?
Yes.
And why would he beat you?
Because he saw me... He wanted me to, I guess maybe, I don't know if I was his golden child or whatever it was.
In a BBC interview, Joe Jackson admitted whipping Michael with a switch or a belt, but denied ever beating him. Beating, Joe maintained, is something you do with a stick. Success at such a cost left Jackson with conflicted feelings for his father.
Now, on the one hand, he would always complain. My father didn't love me enough. My father made me into a performance machine. My father was too strict. He was too much of a disciplinarian. He made me rehearse too much. I would see kids on the monkey bars, and I would cry because I couldn't have a childhood.
Rabbi Shmuley Boteach was a friend and spiritual advisor to Michael Jackson.
I said to him, okay, but look at the flip side of that. Because of that, you became a big performer, and maybe even because you were not given enough love as a child, you wanted the world's love. So you worked really hard, perfecting your dance moves, and you became a big superstar. Would you trade it in for a normal childhood and give up a celebrity? And interestingly, he'd say to me every time, no, I wouldn't do that.
Jackson and his brothers would become preteen idols, appearing in commercials and on magazine covers. However, Jackson's teenage years were awkward. He suffered from bad acne and was self-conscious of his appearance.
He did say to me that he was once on an airplane and his father said to him, you know, your nose isn't nice, or something like that. And generally, he expressed to me that he was made to feel that he was ugly, that he was not pretty. And sadly, he really internalized that message.
By 1975, the Jackson 5 had made a highly publicized split from Motown, and Michael Jackson was ready to spread his wings. Jackson would turn to Quincy Jones, then musical director for The Wiz, now a multi-Grammy-winning producer, arranger, and composer.
I said, you know what? I'd like to take a shot at producing a record. And we started going. We started to get going, and the record company said, no, Quincy's too jazzy. He's not the person to do this. And so Michael and his managers fought them and said, Quincy's doing the record.
Legendary music producer Quincy Jones would produce Jackson's first adult solo album, 1979's Off the Wall. The album was a smash, with songs like Don't Stop Till You Get Enough and Rock With You reaching number one.
This is the greatest moment that disco has in its entire history.
They are songs that still hold up today. They don't sound dated. I guess what none of us could have anticipated was the album that they would then produce after Off the Wall.
That album was 1982's Thriller, and it would catch fire when Jackson unveiled an out-of-this-world dance move on a television special for Motown's 25th anniversary.
What a moment that was in pop culture history when he moonwalked across the stage there.
So he's doing the moonwalk, which when he first did it nationally, it was like, wait, is gravity being like messed with here? Special effects? Like, what are we doing? And I mean, you know, within 6 months, every 10-year-old in Dallas could do it.
The transformation was complete. Michael Jackson was about to go from child pop star to the biggest star on the planet. When we continue, Chimps, Oxygen Chambers, The Elephant Man's Bones, Michael Jackson's bizarre behavior.